What's up, agents, and welcome to my channel. My name is Chris Contagious, and today I'm bringing you guys another Division video. And in this video, I'm bringing you guys a vendor reset with guide roll weapons, mods, and of course, gear. So in this week, we got a really great surplus SPD blueprint, which is super great for any Deadeye and Sentry build. So I would suggest you guys definitely pick this up. It already comes with Disciplined, which is super OP, and it's probably one of the best marksman's rifles within the game, at least in my opinion anyway. And over at the special equipment vendor, we have a tactical vest, which has the talent and vigorous grants overheal to all healing skills. I would probably switch out enemy armor damage and just go for health. This could be good for so many ninja bike builds, so I would suggest you guys go over and grab this and reroll for whatever preference you would like, dependent on the build you're currently trying to run. So yeah, this is just a great vigorous chest piece you guys need to go and pick up. And then we had a specialized backpack. Firearms adds 200% of firearms and stamina to your skill power. Already has health. I would roll probably disrupt resistance for something else, dependent on the current build you guys are actually trying to run. All preference right now. But yeah, that's it for the special equipment vendor, and we're gonna be heading upstairs to the advanced vendor. So yeah, this week has some really god roll weapons, armor, and even mods. There's a couple god roll mods that you guys definitely need to pick up, and everything I add into this video are must buys. You guys need to add these to your stash. So yeah, let's go down to the lightweight M4 with 17.2k damage, 18% enemy armor. No, it's actually 22% enemy armor damage. Skilled Unforgiven Self-Reserve. Pretty good. Gear score of 265, sold for about 1.6. So yeah, it's a good one. It's not as better as the one I currently have, which is currently PB. But for this one, you could roll this one for PvP. You just have to put some D-Tech into it. It already has Unforgiven, which is super good. Critical Self-Preserve really comes in handy. And now we're going to look at that M870, which is pretty almost god rolled. Has 343 stagger, 272 gear school, adept comp. I'd probably roll out adept for brutal, or actually no, I'd probably go vicious, just because it's a shock, and vicious is really good. And this is just a really great pickup for PvE, and it can be very good in PvP. I've never actually used the M870. I was always a big SASG, and then of course the Showstopper, which is definitely probably one of my favorite weapons within the division. So we're gonna head over to the Dark Zone gear vendor. He has some nice stuff. Let me put it to you lightly. So we're gonna go ahead and check out this tactical chest piece, which has rapid degrees cooldown for healing skills by 15%, skill haste, EDR, and of course increased kill speed. And I'd probably roll out EDR for health, just because it's just really good. And then the max god tier sticky bomb damage prototype performance mod is really good for any reclaimer build. If you're running a reclaimer, you've got to have this. Like, you're running sticky bomb, this amplifies sticky bomb so much. So I would suggest you guys go ahead and make that purchase. So here we are at the weapons vendor. He has a nice scope, critical hit damage, optimal range, and headshot damage. Good for SMGs and of course ARs, depending which one to run. Has headshot, optimal range. Now I'd like crit hit chance in there, but you know, the odds of that happening are very low. So go ahead and pick up this prototype firearms mod. It's not 4% damage elites, which I currently have. And the one I currently has 211 farms, and this one's only 186. Is not god rolled, but if you don't have a damaged farms, damage to elites, I suggest you guys go ahead and pick that one up because you know it's still pretty decent. So now we're gonna head over to Camp Clinton. We're gonna go ahead and check out the blueprint vendor, which he has a. There's a nice little vendor in there. So over here, they have a pretty much god rolled nice, and I mean nice, G36. So this is pretty god tier for PvE, and I would highly, and I mean I would highly suggest you pick this up if you don't have already a really good PvE weapon. Now I like to roll commanding and determined for PvE. But if you know, if I had destructive, that would be, you know, that would be my god roll. And of course, don't forget about the small grip red blueprint. I can't actually purchase this because I don't really have, well, I actually do, but I'm trying to save them for recalibrations and stuff like that. So yeah, that's a really good pickup. Already has critted damage, you can roll for critted chance and headshot. Then that would be really great. And here we are, the G36 enhanced. It has unforgiven, ferocious, and focused. This, you really don't have to roll this. You might want to put some detect to increase the damage, which is already 19.4 compared to the lightweight, which can get, I think, a high of 17.7, or is it 9? It could be 18.1 to be sure. But this G36 is a really, really god tier roll. It's 1,240 Phoenix credits. And now we're gonna be looking at the M700 carbine. Already has vicious, which is actually pretty nice one, marksman. Elevated, competent. I'd roll out elevated and go for brutal or even disciplined. Like those would be god tier for any marksman build, especially for Deadeye and Sentry. You know, just really good builds. So now we're gonna go ahead and check out this prototype performance mod. 7% support station range. This is what you want for any healing reclaimer build. This is pretty perfect. So if you guys need to pick this up, I suggest you guys do it this week, because that's just a really great mod for any reclaimer build, especially if you're going to be running some resistance. Like that's every resistant group needs a support station, and I suggest you guys highly pick that up. So we're gonna be heading over to the cavern, which actually has a pretty nice tenacious mask that would be a really good pickup for any ninja bike build. So yeah, it's pretty essential. So pretty much all the weapons, armors, gears, and mods that you can pick up this week that I have in this video are just pretty god tier. So I'd highly suggest picking up all of it. If you don't currently have something better, just put it in your stash for a later build. So here's the tenacious mask. Firearms increase damage by 10% for 10 seconds when using a medkit. Critic chance and burn resistance. You could probably switch out burn resistance for maybe a, well, just really it's all preference. It's already god rolled crit chance. I mean, that's pretty good. You can roll out burn resistance for, you know, whatever your preference might be. So yeah, now we're gonna be heading over to the Southpaw safe house. There's actually an electronics slash health mod which has a quite a bit of health, but it's kind of on the lower side of the electronics, but it's just something really great. You can just stick in your stash, come back later if you need it. It's really good for if you're not feeling as tanky when you're running like a reclaimer or a different skill build. where you're not feeling as tanky, you're taking too much damage, this health isn't really gonna set you right. So yeah, I definitely suggest you guys highly, highly recommend picking this up. And next, we're gonna go and check out a really, and I mean a really, 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 really great LMG. So yeah, we're gonna be heading over. I always forget the these locations for the DZ. So yeah, I'm always skipping ahead. I know it's not Park Avenue, but it's over here at the East 53rd Street. There's an 8 great LMG you guys are gonna wanna buy if you have the Dark Zone credits. Now, if you're a newer player who don't have Dark Zone credits, you're gonna miss out this week. Because the Dark Zone vendors have some really good stuff. Better than they usually do. So yeah, I highly suggest picking up this LMG. So the military RPK 74M, which would be super good for any Lone Star build. I know a lot of you like to run that MD5 for any Lone Star build, as well as the Alejandro. But this is a really good pickup because Alejandro drop rate is super low. Destructor, Predatory, and already has Unforgiven. So yeah, this would even be good for PvP group play with a Lone Star. Predatory, Unforgiven, Destructor. Well, you probably wanna roll out Destructor for maybe responsive or something at a longer range, because technically, if you're running an LMG, you would want to be at like a further range. So think about that if you're gonna purchase the RPK. Next, we're gonna be heading to the East 31st Street. I'm pretty sure they have a Seeker damage mod, which is God tier, and I highly recommend picking this up. I already have it, or else I would be buying it. So yeah, 4% Seeker mine damage. I love running Seeker builds. They're just too much fun not to play with. So yeah, highly recommend picking this up. 4% Seeker mine damage. It's really good for legendary solo and legendary missions. So yeah, you definitely want to make sure you go ahead and pick that one up. And next but not least, oh yeah, there's a firearms slash skill power mod over at the West 31st Street. This is also a must pick up, highly recommend. Good for so many different builds. So let's go ahead and check that out. So yeah, here it is, almost max firearms, 3,134 skill power for 21,362 Dark Zone funds. A must pick up, of course. That firearms is really high. And then the large suppressor FDE, critted damage, critted chance, accuracy. If it had headshot damage, it would be almost god roll. Well, although it could have a higher critted chance. But this is a really good suppressor if you don't already own a god roll one. And next, we're going to be going over to almost a max god tier first aid ally heal over at the West 42nd Street. It's a 5.50 first aid heal. It's really good if you don't already have like the 6% one, which it's kind of hard to find, to be honest. So yeah, here he is at the West 42nd Street Dark Zone vendor. So if you don't already have a 6% first aid ally heal, I highly suggest picking this one up. It's so good. It could be very good for a very different situation, especially if you're running Reclaimer, although you wouldn't necessarily run that, but still good for PvP. Because that first aid ally heal will save you multiple times, especially if you're running a support station box. And over at the West 53rd Street, creeds. They have a SASG that I also highly recommend picking up. Before I ran the Showstopper, this was my go-to weapon. I always ran this, especially for striker builds. It's really good for helping you get your stacks. Responsive and Forgiven are really good for PvP. So this is a very good PvP weapon for 416 and 160 Dark Zone funds. I'd switch out Talented for maybe. There's so many you could go Brutal, Deadly. You could even go Vicious, which would be really good. But if you guys enjoyed the video, please go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe if you're new to the channel. Thanks for watching.